Hello and welcome to the Dress My Craft YouTube channel. I'm Ujjwal and today we will be talking about the new die cutting machine. But before we do that, don't forget to click the subscribe button, like, share and of course comment on our videos. So this is the newly released Easy Cuts die cutting machine. It's a miniature version and it comes packaged neatly in this little box, which has some details about the machine, and as you can see, it is a die cutting as well as an embossing machine. And the package contains three things. One is the instruction manual, then you get a pair of clear acrylic plates, and then there is the machine itself. So let's look at all the things one by one. The first thing here is the instruction manual. If you are a newbie or if you are new to die cutting, this manual instruction would be really helpful for you. It has all the details about how the machine works, and then has some card sample on the front page, and then you get these instructions for how to make your sandwiches for the die cutting machine and what kind of materials it can cut and how to clean it and how to maintain it and everything. So this little booklet would be really useful for you if you are, you know, getting started, or if you are new to die cutting and don't understand how it works. So next is this set of clear plates. Now I have to say, these are like really good quality. Once you hold them in your hand, you can actually feel how good quality they are, and they are, of course, they have tapered edges, so it is easier to roll them in the machine. And then there is the machine itself, of course, and you can see how cute and tiny this is. It actually fits in the palm of my hand, and that makes it really, really portable, so you can carry it anywhere, even if you're traveling and to, you know, take your craft supplies with you like I do most of the time. I think this will come in really handy. Another thing that I really like about this machine is the expandable platform. So there are other mini die cutting machines out there, but they don't come with the expandable arm, and it's difficult to kind of you know, place your sandwich in there. You have to constantly hold it. But since this one has the expandable arm, your sandwich, the plates, once you're moving inside, can actually come and go in easily. So that is one thing I would really like. The next thing that I wanted to mention is it has these rubber grips to hold it in place. So it is there on the expandable arm as well as underneath. And this provides the machine some stability when you are actually die cutting it. So this is how it looks when it is completely open. And let's see the size that these plates support. So measuring here, the plates are 3 inches wide and 6 inches long. And this is a pretty decent good size. Now let's move on and see how the machine actually functions or works. So here I have some of my favorite Dress My Craft dies, and I have the machine out, and you can see I've opened it up and it's not moving much, so it's like stable, it's not wonky. And before I get started on how to make a sandwich, I wanted to show you that even though this is a mini die cutting machine, most of the dies, I'd say about 70 to 80% of the dies that you have in your stash are from Dress My Craft or even from other brands, you will be able to fit all of those in here, except maybe the large dies like the background dies and maybe the nestabilities, the larger size, the bigger size, those won't fit in. But other than that, you can fit in a lot of dies here. So that is one thing that I feel is really important that you know, because most of the time when it comes to mini die cutting machine, we feel and we have this image in mind that it'll only take in small dies. But actually, if you see, so you can see that that foliage fits in there perfectly. Now I have one of the flower making dies and the largest flower fits in there perfectly as well. So all I'm trying to say is that, you know, we have this picture in our mind that it's a mini die cutting machine and would take only small dies, but that might not be the case. So before you make a decision, I would strongly suggest that you consider all of these points and then decide what to buy and if to buy and which size to buy. All right, so let's start doing some die cutting and see how the machine actually works. So today I am using the Floral Oriental collection. This is 285 GSM, which is pretty thick, and I want to see if the machine would be able to cut such thick paper. And the die that I'm using is the Christmas Ornaments die from the Christmas Dies release. This is from Dress My Craft, of course. So I chose this die for two reasons. One, because it's almost Christmas and I wanted to create something Christmassy. And second reason was that this particular die set has a mix of different varieties. So there's a solid ornament, then there is an intricate ornament, and then one that also has some embossing details. So I thought it would be perfect to see how all of these cut out using this particular machine. So I've cut the paper to size to fit my 3-inch wide plate here, and I'm going to cut this intricate one first. So I have to be honest here, I did have to run the plates a few times before I got a clean cut, but at the end I did get a clean cut. So you might have to, for intricate dies, either you can use a little shim, so add something additional so there is more pressure on the die, or you could just kind of run it a few times and then see how it happens. And once it is cut, I'm using the super handy ultimate die cleaning tool to just, you know, poke out all the excess parts and just clean the die cut. And here you can see that I managed to get this really crisp, clean die cut with this particular machine. This is with the paper that's 285 GSM. So I would say that this works pretty well. And now, just to experiment, I'm going to cut out a few more pieces. I also cut out one with some glitter foam, and the one with the foam also came out really crisp and nice. And I also had to go through the rolling machine fewer number of times than I had to do with the paper. Maybe because of the height of the foam, it's a little bit thicker than the paper, so it cuts off even well. So yeah, I liked how the foam one came out. So I cleaned the die cut with my ultimate die cleaning tool, and you can see even the teeny parts that were inside have come out very crisp and clear, and the ornament looks great in golden glitter. So let's move on and do some more die cutting and create some fun, wonderful projects. So I die cut a few different pieces of ornaments. I did one with foam, then the rest three with the floral oriental paper, and even the embossed one came out really well. So I'm creating some Christmas stacks today, and I'm using the non-stick craft mat from Dress My Craft because I will be using some distress oxides. So this particular thing makes it really easy to clean the surface and works really well. So I have the distress oxides in Broken China and Faded Jeans, these two colors. I already went ahead and cut out some tags. So these measure about, I think, 3 inches by 5 inches. And we are going to just quickly add some color to the background. So I'm starting with the Broken China here and adding a color. I'm not really worried about blending here. So I'm just going to quickly add a coat of color with a blending brush. And I'm keeping the first coat of color mostly towards the center. And then I'm moving on to the Faded Jeans color, Distress Oxide. And this one I'll be adding more towards the edges, so it kind of has that glowing effect in the center. So a lighter color in the center and then a darker one around the edges to create the illusion of light. And then just blend. And once you are happy with the blended color, I'm just using a spray bottle and spraying some water to create some splashes. Distress oxides react with water, and once it dries, you'll see a beautiful effect. So now I'm going to do the same thing with the second one as well. I'm not sure how many dies I want to create at this point, so I'm just prepping and keeping stuff aside, and I will see, mix and match, and see what I want to create at the end.
So same thing with this one as well. Darker color on the edges, and then a water splash, and then we are going to let it dry. And this is the one that we sprayed before, and you can see the oxidization happening there. It's lifted off the color and has left this white splash, and it looks absolutely beautiful. So now let's prepare our other stuff and let's start assembling our tags. And here I am coloring the two ornaments using the same colors as well, and same technique too. So lighter color first, and then around the edges I will go in with the darker color. So faded jeans around the edges, and then the broken china towards the center, and this will again create that kind of glowy effect. Now when you add the color, you might feel like it's all blotchy and spotchy, but once it dries, it will blend in even more, and it will look seamless. So don't worry if it looks blotchy in the beginning. It will settle down and look good once it dries. So alright, I think I have all the parts that I need, and one thing that I love doing is using the negatives. I absolutely hate wasting paper, so I have my Dress My Craft trimmer here, and I am cutting out those negatives. I often plan my die cuts in a way that I can use the negatives. So here you can see I've left ample space in between each of those ornaments so that I can cut it and use them later. So I will be using this as one of the tags as well. And now to make the tag look even more interesting and add a new shape, I'm using this banner punch to punch the edge of one of the negative tags that I've created here. And the paper is slightly bigger than the slots available, so I'm just kind of centering it using holding the punch backwards so that I can see where it is punching. And this is also a great trick. So you see, I have got this little banner shape, and it will look great as a tag. Then I also decided to add some color to this negative as well, just to maintain the theme of our blue and gold and white. And again, doing the same thing, the lighter color and the darker color on the edges. And of course, a water splash, and then we are going to let it dry. Now I'm putting down some ink on my craft mat here, and we're going to add some blue splatters on the white cardstock. So I'm adding some water, and I'm going to use a little brush and add some splatters to this white cardstock. And then of course we're going to let it dry and start assembling our pieces. So I just went ahead and just did a little mix and match and figured out what I like what combination of tags I like and where I want all the pieces to be. And before we start sampling, I also wanted to add some more glitter to my other ornaments. So I'm using the Microfine sparkling dust and adding some glue randomly to the ornaments and then sprinkling the dust and making them super sparkly. And now finally it's the fun part. It's where we assemble and put everything together. So I'm just going to speed up this process, and I hope you enjoy it and enjoy seeing me create these tags. So I hope you enjoyed watching me create these tags and found some all the tips and tricks that I shared useful. So this is the machine. If you're new to die cutting or if you already have one, still I would recommend a small die cutting machine. They're super handy, very portable, and yeah, something you can have at your desk at all times. So do give it a try, and if you buy the machine or if you give any of these techniques that I shared today a try, do share with us. We have our official group on Facebook where you can share your Dress My Craft creations. And yeah, and if you like the video, don't forget to like it and subscribe to the channel, and I will see you again next time. Bye bye.